Welcome to the Words to Empower podcast, featuring Bishop Frank Stewart, pastor of the Acts Ministry in Conway and North Little Rock, and now, Pastor Stewart.
In Genesis chapter number 40, starting at verse 9, I'm reading from the New King James Version. It says, "Then the chief butler told his dream to Joseph and said to him, 'Behold, in my dream a vine was before me, and in the vine were three branches. It was as though it budded, its blossoms shot forth, and its clusters brought forth ripe grapes. Then Pharaoh's cup was in my hand, and I took the grapes, pressed them into Pharaoh's cup, and placed the cup in Pharaoh's hand.'" You see that? Look at somebody and say, "It was a dream." Because it takes grapes about 3 years to produce some grapes. It takes a vine about 3 years, and then it takes about 10 years to really produce grapes. To really have a good harvest, it takes a vine that exists. But what the man said in his dream, he saw all of it happen quickly. It's a rapture. But look at somebody said, "But it's just a dream." Mark chapter 4, verse 26. Just a dream, right? Just a dream. Just a dream. You've got to put a question mark behind that statement. Was it just a dream? See, I believe you can be in poverty and God snatch you to a whole nother place. We'd have no problem believing people being rich and losing everything in a minute. People was rich and they lost everything and started jumping out of windows. See, we don't have a problem with great day and all of a sudden something happened. Boom. In Mark chapter 4, and I want to just, Jesus is teaching. Well, I'll read it. I started verse 26 just for clarity. "And Jesus said, 'The kingdom of God is as if a man should scatter seed on the ground. And should sleep by night and rise by day. And the seed should sprout and grow. He himself does not know how. For the earth yields crops by itself.'" Say, "First the blade. Then the head. And then the full grain in the head." You see that? Now let me read for you the New Living Translation. It says, "The earth produces the crops on its own. First, a leaf blade pushes through." Now, he's talking to farmers. They understand this. Some of us don't understand it. When you plant a seed, it pushes through the ground. The reason why it pushes through the ground, it has to germinate. It has to die. Now, this is a secret here. It's one of the things he's saying to us. The quicker you die, I ain't got time to eat. See, we control the germination. Oh, God. Don't do me like that. Please. Not now. Okay, I'll come back to that later. Watch this. So it pushes through. Okay? Pushes through the ground. Jonah chapter 4. Run to Jonah chapter 4 and verse 4. Jonah 4 and 4. So he's given us a process. He gives us a process. It starts off with the leaf pushing through. And after it pushed through, it pushed the ground, then it gets up, it's bent over, then it goes through the transformation. And it takes years to get where it's producing. All right? Now, Joseph told us about the man had a dream. The butler had a dream that all of it happened at once. But it was only a dream, right? And Jonah, now Jonah's in the Old Testament. Jonah chapter 4. It says in verse 4, chapter 4, verse 4, "Then the Lord said," he's talking to Jonah, "'Is it right for you to be angry?'" Wow. See, when you deal with anger management, I'm telling you, these questions they're going to ask you in anger management, the same one God asked Jonah, and the first question he asked Cain in the book of Genesis. What was the question God asked Cain about anger? Why are you angry? See, sometimes people are angry. They take it out on what they see. But the anger is about something else. You can be angry from stuff that happened in childhood, but take it out on the people that don't know anything about it 20, 30 years later. All right? So those are questions that God will say, hey, why are you angry? Verse 5, so Jonah went out of the city and sat on the east side of the city. There he made himself a shelter and sat under its shade till he might see what would become of the city. Jonah prophesied to the city that God was going to destroy it. All right? And so he went and sat outside of the city to watch God rain down fire and destroy the whole city. Messed up prophet. Messed up preacher. See, he's angry. All right? Now watch this. It says in verse number 6, and the Lord God prepared a plant and made it come up over Jonah, that it might be shade for his head to deliver him from his misery.
Right. Stay tuned for more of Frank Stewart. And now for some special announcements.
Thanks for partnering with the Acts Ministries. We value your service and your donations. That's why we've made it easy to make contributions to support our ministry. Simply go to your web browser and click the search bar and type in acsministriesonline.org. Then click Donate Online. It's really that easy. For mobile giving, text the amount you wish to donate to 501-302-4242. That's Simple Give.
And now, more of Pastor Frank Stewart.
And one day, God grew a plant. Look at somebody and said, this is not a dream. God grew a plant. God can deliver immediately. Matter of fact, he has already delivered on the cross. Deliverance is in the past tense when it comes to healing and sickness and diseases. We're trying to cooperate with God and receive it. It's already done. It's done. So I don't have to worry about if it's God's will to heal me. He's already done it, so I don't have to deal with that. And I need to know that's his will when I go to him. Because the Bible says when we go and we petition him, we have to know it's his will. And if we know it's his will, this is the confidence that we have in him, that if we ask anything according to his will, he hears us, and we have the petition, we have what we ask. So I don't have to worry about it being his will for healing. He's already done it, so I know it's his will to heal me. I got to learn how to cooperate. And many times we got to cooperate in our emotions, because most of our sickness and our diseases come from our emotions. Made a plant. Shade. One day. Numbers chapter 17. Verse 7. Numbers. Genesis, Exodus, Leviticus. What? Numbers. New members, they learn in the books of the Bible how to say what? Backwards. And that's a small thing. Should be so familiar with the Bible that you can do it backwards. Some of us struggle doing it forward. But we having too much church. Watch this. Numbers chapter 17, verse 7. And Moses placed the rods, 12 of them, before the Lord in the tabernacle of witness. Oh, Father, I hear you talking. Now it came to pass on the next day that Moses went into the tabernacle of witness, and behold, the rod of Aaron of the house of Levi had sprouted, put forth buds, had produced blossoms, and yielded ripe almonds. Oh, God. Look, somebody said, this is not a dream. It's called a miracle. In the presence of God. An almond tree, it takes about 4 years for almond tree to grow. 4 years. He said the next day. Say the next day. See, now watch this. You gotta listen to me. Really listen to me. God created time. And everything God created He put it under Adam's feet.
Oh, they didn't get it over there. Let me see. I go over here.
Everything God created, He gave man dominion over it. What you said, Joshua? I need some more time. Need some more time, God? God said you need some more time? Let me go ahead and just stop my stopwatch. What is God's stopwatch? The sun and the moon. Hear me. He doesn't have to do that to control time. In the presence of the Lord, they took, you see, really, this is not fair at all. It was a rod, it was a stick that cut off that Aaron had for years and years and years. It wasn't even any green in it. The stick had petrified. Look at somebody, say, do you know what it means to petrify? Yeah. That means it became like a stone. Yeah. No life in it, cut off. But they messed around and put it in the presence of God. Oh. And in the presence of God, what would take a seed 4 years, and it was impossible for this to do, it took the next day. And I don't believe it took 24 hours for him to do it. That's why I don't believe with some scientists say, well, the first day could be 1,000 years when God's creating the world. You misinterpret scriptures from the book of Peter. God don't need 1,000 years to do it. God just... So that's why when people have chemo and stuff and they come in cooperation with God, in contact with God, and they get their stress level right, and they start believing God, and they go to the doctor, and the doctor say, you want to have so many chemo treatment. Then he come back and say, you ain't gonna need that many treatment. What happened? In the presence of God, He speeds up. I'm going to try to keep from hooping today because this is not a hooping church. But He speeds up time. And a 4-year process was the next day. Anything you wait that you know is going to take 4 years for you to do. Someone's looking at it and say, you know, my mortgage is 10 years left, 15 years left. My mortgage is 30 years left.
For mobile giving, text the amount you wish to donate to 501-302-4242.
The Axe Church in North Little Rock is located at 1224 Franklin Street. Morning Glory begins at 8 a.m. on Sunday mornings. Sunday School begins at 8:30 a.m. And for a powerful word, join us at 9:30 a.m. for our morning worship service. Bible study is each Wednesday at 6:30 p.m. At our Conway location, Morning Glory begins at 10 a.m. Sunday School begins at 10:30 a.m. Worship service begins at 11:30 a.m. On Thursday, our Bible class begins at 6:30 p.m. For more information, go to axeministriesonline.org or give us a call at 501-329-2055.
Thank you for tuning in to the Axe Ministry Podcast. The Axe Church is located at 1423 Ingram Street in Conway and 1224 Franklin Street in North Little Rock, Arkansas. Tune in each day to hear an inspiring word from Pastor Frank Stewart.
Day by day, no more reaction. from my center, Jackson. Every beat of my heartbeat is your song.
Hurt and harm, you're my protection. The path I take is your direction. Cause I know with you I can go.
There's no letting go.
So let me be the first to say
I'm lost without you.
So don't ever go.
Go away. Say don't ever go away.
You pick me up those times I'm down. You make me laugh. There's no clown, no one else can love me like you do.
Heaven knows that I proclaim the love I feel when I hear your name. There's no substitution quite the same. Now some say I'm crazy and I'm acting insane, but there's no life without you. So I'll state my claim. Oh,
I'm lost without you.
It's easy to see
I'm lost without you.
So I just keep holding on.
So let me be the first to say
I'm lost without you.
So don't ever go.
Don't ever go.
Go away. That's what I love about it. That's what I love about it.